just said no scholar ever says the five books of Moses is corrupted.
No, I said from the Christian worldview.
Hang on. Are you saying scholars of the Old Testament?
Not to be biased.
So are you saying the people who believe in the Old Testament to be from God, those kind of scholars don't say it's corrupt, but there may be other scholars who don't believe in the Old Testament, they can say it's corrupt? So now, your scholarly approach to this conversation is this. I accept the scholars who only accept our view. That is not scholarship, my friend. Scholarship doesn't mean I only take from Christian scholars. What about atheist scholars? What about scholars who are non-Christians? You're saying, no, we cannot take any of the scholarship? Okay, let me carry on. So, I'm asking you again once more. When we talk about the Torah, are we talking about the Torah which is the Masoretic text, the Hebrew version, the Jewish people have, like the Jewish Publication Society, JPS? Or am I going to take the Greek version, the Septuagint, the LXX, which one?
Let's go by the Septuagint.
Which one?
Just say the Septuagint.
Which one?
Go with the Septuagint.
No, I'm asking you, which one?
No, I'm saying no in the Christian worldview.
You did not know this, did you? So basically, he's not aware there are different versions of the Torah. He's not aware of it.
Which doesn't work on this context. Allah, revealer, Allah who reveals the Torah.
Yeah.
And reveal the Injil.
Mm-hmm.
And reveal the Quran.
Where is it? Where is it? No, no, I want to know, where is the Torah that Allah revealed?
With due respect, show me in the Quran where Allah, who revealed the Torah and revealed the angel, said the Torah that I revealed is corrupt. Simple.
I am asking you to understand this.
Is that a clear question, my brother?
Yeah, and hear my clear answer. The Quran, in various ways, demonstrates that the Torah and the Injil of the Christians, whatever they have in their hands, possesses, right? There were many things which they added to it by themselves. They wrote with their own hands. Shall I show you some?
That's not the question I asked.
What does corruption mean? Corruption is by additions, omissions, and alterations. Do you know what? Corruption. Corruption of the text can happen by adding to the text, taking away from the text, or changing the text.
But Quran said the words of Allah cannot be changed.
What does it mean?
The words that Allah has revealed.
What does it mean?
Cannot be changed.
Do you know what it means?
You are saying to me.
Let me tell you what it means.
You are
because you do not understand, let me tell you what it means. When Allah says, no one can change the words of Allah, in the context that you have read them, you never asked, what does it mean? Does it mean a divine scripture or does it mean his promise? In the context, firstly, show me where it says that and I'll tell you what it says. I am going to. Go and show me where Allah says, no one can change the words of Allah. Excuse me.
A very simple question.
When the Quran says no one can change the words of Allah, if you look at the context, it tells that no one can change anything that because Allah's promise is true. He is not going to change his promise.
Please, with due respect, you know why is like show me where the Quran says Allah said that the Torah that I revealed.
I just told you. Allah says
it's not corrupt.
Allah says, okay. Do you understand?
Because if the words of Allah cannot be changed, why are you...
Firstly, you made several points here, right? These points need to be examined. You made a statement that no one... Look at his logical process. Allah says no one can change his words, and Allah revealed the Torah. That means no one can change the Torah. Are you saying the book by the Jehovah's Witnesses, called the Bible, is not a corrupt version of the Bible? Now you're saying, oh God, God's words, look, God's word according to you can never be changed. And yet we have the Jehovah's Witnesses, we have the Book of Mormons, and we have the Coptics, we have the Catholics, we have the Protestants, and they are different number of books and so on and so forth. According to your own logic, no one can change the words of God, and now you have these words of God changed. That means none of them are words of God, according to the extension of logic.